is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing hand them, to die, to sleep
no more, and by asleep to say we handed heartache, or the 2000 natural shocks that flesh is heir to. This is a consummation devoutly to be wished, to die, to sleep.
Lend me not to the marriage of two minds, admit impediments. Love is not love, which alters when its alteration finds. Her bends with the remover to remove. Oh no, it is on ever fixed mark that looks on tempest and is never shaken. It is the start to every wandering back, whose worth unknown, also is aid be taken.
Love is not time's fool. Talk rosy lips and cheeks, waiting is baiting, cycles compass come. Love alters not, with its brief hours and weeks, but bears it out even to the age of doom. If his behavior, and upon me prove it, I never write, no, no man ever loved.
Which he did thrice refuse, was his ambition. Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and sure he is an honorable man. I speak not to disprove what Brutus spoke, but here I am to speak what I do know. You all did love him once, not with a cause. What cause withhold you then to mourn for him? Oh, judgment, through heart fled down to British beast, and men have lost their reason. Bear with me. My heart is in the coffin there with Caesar, and I must pause till he come back to me.
No longer mourn for me when I'm dead. Then you shall hear the surly sounding bell give warning to the world that I'm fled from this vile world with the vilest worm to dwell. Nay, if you read this line, remember not the hand that wrote it, for I love you so that I'm yours with thoughts would be forgot. If thinking on me, then should make you woe.
Oh, if I say you look upon this verse, when a parrot commune the dumb with clay, though not so much as my poor name rehears, but let your love even with my life decay.
Love me or hate me, both are in my favor. If you love me, I'll always be in your heart. If you hate me, I'll always be in your mind.
Life's but a walking shadow, a poor player that struts and fills his hour upon the stage, and then is there no more. It is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and the summer's leaves are all too short to date. Sometime to art the eye of heaven shines, and often is his gold complexion dimmed, and every fair from fair sometime declines. By chance, or nature's changing course, untrimmed.
But the eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose possession of that fair to host, nor shall that brag to wander in his shade, when in eternal lines to the two grows, so long as man can breathe or eyes can see. So long lives this, and this gives life to thee.
We know what we are, but know not what we may be.
My mistress' eyes are nothing like the sun. Coral is far more red than her lips red. If snow be white, why then her breezes are done. If fairs be wires, black wires grow on her head. I have seen roses damasked red and white, but no such roses see I in her cheeks. And in some perfumes is there more delight than in the breath that from my mistress reeks.
I love to hear her speak, yet will I know that music at a far more pleasing sound. I grant, I never saw a goodness go. My mistress, when she walks, treads on the ground, and yet, by heaven, I think my love as well as any she belied with false compare.
If music be the food of love, play on.
Some are born great, some assure greatness, and some eurythmes trust upon them.
All the world's a stage, and all the men and the women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his time plays many parts.
You are my soul speak. Of the very instant that I saw you, did my heart fly at your service.
When, in disgrace with fortune and men's eyes, I all alone beweep my outcast state, and trouble the heaven with my bootless cries, I look upon myself and curse my fate, wishing me like to one more rich in hope, featured like him with friends possessed, desiring this man's heart and that man's scope, with what I call enjoy content least, yet in this too, myself almost despising, happily think on thee and then my state, like to the lark at the bray of the arising, from sullen hearth sings hymns to heaven's gate.
For 'tis with love, remembered, such wealth brings,
that then I scorn to change my state with kings.
That though the stars are fire, that the sun doth move, that truth to be a liar, but never that I love.
Ebbene, we have seen better days, ma le cose miglioreranno e grazie ai nostri giovani che ascoltano il bisbiglio dei libri che aspettano di essere letti, il nostro futuro will be better. Leggete una poesia, un romanzo, un saggio, una play, immergete, vivete mille sentimenti, infinite emozioni, 100.000 vite e poi siate voi stessi sempre. Grazie.